This is Dr. Carlo Oger, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. This video is about contact dermatitis. If you have contact dermatitis and your symptoms become worse, even with treatment, you should come back to the emergency department. Also, if you develop signs of infection of the affected areas like redness, pus, pain, swelling, or fever. If there are any new symptoms or concerns that were not addressed initially, please come back for reevaluation. Contact dermatitis is an irritation of the skin caused by contact with something. Sometimes the rash is due to an allergic reaction, sometimes the rash is due to a simple chemical irritation. The symptoms include itching, redness of the skin, along with blistering in more severe cases. Although this condition is rarely dangerous, it can be very frustrating. Examples of items which can cause contact dermatitis include detergents, soaps, shampoos, nickel, found in jewelry, poison ivy, poison oak, wool, clothing starch, and cleaning fluids. In many cases, the item that caused the rash cannot be identified. If you have many episodes of contact dermatitis, you should see a dermatologist or skin doctor, or an allergist to undergo testing to determine the cause of your reaction. If you are fortunate enough to know what caused your rash, you will be able to avoid that substance in the future. Treatment. Use of antihistamines or anti-itch medicines. Antihistamines such as over-the-counter Benadryl or prescription-strength Atarax can be used to help limit your itching. Because antihistamines can make you drowsy, use caution and avoid them if you must be alert at work. Use of steroid or cortisone cream. Steroid creams should be applied sparingly in small amounts 2 times each day over the affected areas. This cream can be used until the skin irritation is gone and the skin feels normal to the touch. Steroid creams should be applied to clean, damp skin and then covered with a thick layer of moisturizer. As a general rule, steroid cream should not be used on the face for longer than 7 days or in other areas of the body for more than 14 days, unless your doctor tells you otherwise. When the reaction is over the whole body, we use a prednisolone pack or steroids over a 1 or even 2 week period because of the rebound reaction that occurs if you withdraw from the steroids too quickly. Use of moisturizers. Skin moisturizer should be applied many times per day. 5 times or more is reasonable. A good moisturizer should seal in water and moisture to the skin. They should be used directly after on top of steroid creams and then additionally alone many more times to keep the skin from looking and feeling dry. You should use greasy, stiff moisturizers that are too thick to pour. Eucerin cream, not lotion, is an example of a good over-the-counter brand. Vaseline and even Crisco cream are good examples of less expensive but good skin moisturizers. Follow-up. It's important to follow up with your primary care doctor to make sure you're healing well and that there's no evidence of superinfection or secondary infection of the skin lesions. Also, if you need any other testing for allergic type reactions or desensitization, and follow up with allergists. For more videos like this video, please visit edexitvideo.com. And remember, these are educational videos and should never replace or take the place of the attention or care of your primary healthcare provider.